Grimes.
Are you warm enough?
Yeah, you.
I am now. I've got my coat zipped up, but I look a bit weird on the video.
Mine was zipped it right up.
Because I'm cold.
Oh, you're worried about it making noises.
You need like a silent heater.
No, we can just do a disclaimer. The easy you can hear this.
That's what I'd do.
Is because we're wearing puffer jackets.
You can't hear it with you can't hear it with this microphone. Because it doesn't work like that. Are you putting lip balm in your ears?
No, I've got something stuck in my ear. It's really driving me mad. I can feel like it hitting me. Things like an earwig or something. Never had that.
Could be. Might be a babblefish.
I read a thing the other day. This is recording, by the way. That dogs drag their arse along the carpet when they've got worms.
Yeah, that's true, that.
And if you've got a really itchy bumhole, mm-hmm. you've probably got worms.
Mm-hmm. Or wash your butthole more often.
Yeah, but I don't know how you get worms.
Have you got an itchy bumhole?
Not right now, but I have in my life at times. You never have it, you think, fucking hell.
Maybe it's just shedding your worms.
That's what makes me wonder.
Mm. I think you just didn't clean your bottle properly after you had a shit.
You don't need to after your mum licks it clean.
Ah. As good at licking as your mum, though. She's good with the
Do you put lip balm in your ears? Is that a thing?
I don't think so.
Then why would you think I was putting lip balm in my ear then?
I didn't. Well, I thought it was weird. That's why I asked, because I thought it was strange.
Look, we're the professionals there. I think it should
be. Oh my God, how many fucking sugars in that tea? You
you're a
what have you put in it?
I went to have a wee.
Sugars.
I went to have a wee and I was like, shit. Did I put sugars?
What have you put in here then?
No, you put that much in because I've said I didn't have sugar. That's why you've done it, you dick.
Did you?
I'm not this person you portray of.
Yes, yeah, that's exactly
so
right.
Petty.
So I'm off sugar. So Paul has put four sugars. How many did you put in my tea?
Oh my God.
No, I think I put half in.
Broke me up.
I think I put half in. Then I was like, shit, I don't like him, so I need to put another five in. Yeah. No, I was like, oh shit, have I put sugar in Clarkies? So I just put another half in.
No, you don't. There's no way, that's just one sugar.
Just drink it. You need some sugar in your system. You've gone really cranky since you went off chocolate.
I think he's always been cranky.
You know, so this morning, Paul, you and I came in a like relaxed, somber mood.
Yeah.
And he skipped in for a change. He's like, oh, you're in a mood today. I'm in a great mood. Like once a fucking month, he comes in with a smile on his face.
He's done it a few days this week. Believe it or not. You wouldn't believe it, would you?
No.
I think he's washed his asshole. Yeah. Worm free. You heard it here first. Rob's worm free this week.
What do you mean this week?
He's probably, Andrew's probably been slipping him the
finger?
The dog worming tablets. He's like, oh, these biscuits are nice. Get off your phone, Robert.
Yeah, I bet I have 10 of them. Yeah, I still regret that.
What?
Such a lovely head of hair.
Grow it back then.
You see, I had a lovely head of hair till my mid 40s. Rob had a lovely head of hair till his mid 14s. I'm joking.
It didn't make it that far.
You put lips still on. Have you put Andrea's lips still on? The stuff with like a tint. I don't feel like I need to wash my butthole with your lips.
When you say Lipsil, was Lipsil a brand?
Yeah.
Lip Salve.
Still, isn't it?
Chapstick was a brand.
Chapstick, yeah.
Lipsil.
And then
you two both look a chapstick.
Lip balm, chapstick. a customer wants to come in because they all look the same in the army. I misses the wrong one of them back there. What was it? And is that chapstick?
Oh,
yes. Hello.
Let's just sit closer to it.
You're welcome.
Yeah, Lipsil.
Why can't they just come closer to the speaker?
Well, they can.
Stop it. Can't get to my boo now. Child.
Says. Have you washed your butthole? Have you washed your ass?
Have you washed your ass today?
We got anything to talk about?
Yeah, I've got a list.
I was hoping you'd have a list.
No, he said he's got a lisp.
I'm just going to say something inappropriate. Yeah, so we are back with our, I don't know, how many of these have we done? Fourth? Fifth? Okay, thanks.
Fourth or fifth?
Fourth or fifth RS chats.
I don't think
someone commented.
Second, maybe.
Probably. Third.
Third.
Third. Yeah, maybe the second or the third. But you can say fourth or the fifth if you want.
He likes to exaggerate things up, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Lost my phone, would you? Yeah, it's right in front of me. So we had a comment on the...
See the look of sheer panic on his face then. What am I going to do without my device?
Martin Futter commented on the last RS chats. Oh, no, not even the last one. He's only just catching up. He's on episode two. Well, that was just like being down the pub on a Saturday afternoon talking bullshit. Loved it. I fancy a pint now. A pint? I fancy a pint now and it's only Wednesday.
Oh, nice.
Well, it's Friday. As we're
it's Friday, the 24th of November.
As we're chatting, and it's not too early for a drink, is it? But it's
Is it too cold for a drink?
We're having a cup of tea. That's probably the.
I would have quite liked a cup of tea, to be honest with you.
One of the problems.
Did you want? Just drink it.
I want it.
Yeah, dip your chocolate in it.
Just man up. Drink it.
It's a good job I'm not a recovering crack addict. You'd be like, this crack's so Moorish, have some.
It's a good job you're not recovering crack addicts anymore.
Anyway, so we're back with another RS Chats. And we have the lovely, 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 lovely Paulie and Rob. And I apologise now.
Hi. Just an and. I just get an and. You get a lovely, lovely, I just get an and.
I think you got a lovely, this lovely,
is,
lovely.
This is because I'm nice and you are not nice.
To be fair, you were nice until you put five sugars in my tea.
Do you really want to know what happened?
Yeah.
That happened. Oh, sorry, guys. It's a podcast, isn't it? I pointed at Robert then.
Well, tell us what happened.
Rob put an extra sugar in your brew. Was in the toilet.
Nothing to do with me.
He ran off laughing to himself like a naughty boy, rubbing his hands together. Like dastardly.
Yeah.
Just try that.
We both kiss the same women, don't we? Fucking hell. Someone else sabotaged that. Got a taste.
I rest my case, Your Honour.
I don't want to be back in the schoolyard.
Hang on. You might have
basically just kissed Clarky.
Yeah. You've rubbed your chapstick all around it. Is it a really sweet cherry one by any chance? That's all I could taste.
I don't have any chapstick. This is him. Saying I've got, am I rubbing chapstick in my ears?
So what was you putting in your ear then?
His lipstick.
Just my finger. I think it was my finger.
Are you double jointed?
I don't even know if we've started this yet.
We haven't. I'll let you know. We haven't.
Rob can introduce it then if he's letting me know we haven't.
We're not started, have we?
I'm sure he can mishmash it all together, can't he?
Okay, guys. Buckle yourself in and get ready for a roller coaster ride of sheer indulgence and fun. Because we're going to have a little chat again.
Yes, we are.
I'm sorry for the noise as well, because these two will insist on wearing these noisy jackets.
It's too cold in here.
It's very cold.
Clark'd rather buy another camera than bloody buy a heater.
Yeah, it's on you. So, no, we've got a heater. It's down there, but we're not allowed it on because it makes too much noise, apparently.
Really?
Because it makes a noise like this. You ready?
Oh. I think we see. Do you mind? We're trying to fucking shoot a video over here, pal.
What's he doing?
I wouldn't put that heater on, Clarky.
What's he doing?
Remember that old radiator without the feet?
Put my electric heater on here so I'm warm.
Oh my God.
Christ. Have you got a fire extinguisher?
I'm actually getting a bit too hot over here.
Put it under the table. You've got to rest on that.
That means we'll have to take our coats off and maybe our pants. Remember the Rogue One 6 video when
I don't know where you plug it in.
Took my pants off.
Oh, do they plug into this? You're taking the piss out of me, aren't you? Will you put that in there? Will you lift that up there? Will you switch it on now? Will you get on there? Can you look after me? I don't know what to do when my mum's not here.
Let's talk about looking after people when you've got it right in front of you.
I don't know what... You just put it there, you bellend.
I know what to do with your mum. I know what to do with your mum.
Do you?
I know what to do with your mum.
Do you?
I thought I was in front of her there because of the echo.
Do you?
God, that's warm, isn't it?
Turn it down then.
Burning. The dust's burning on it.
Oh, my God.
Let's check if it's on fire now, won't we? Clarky, can you please put the video feedback on?
Video feedback?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
What's the telly. Put the telly back on.
Rob's just being mean. Thanks for being my daddy.
Anyway, RS Chats episode, whatever it is.
3, 4, or 5. Possibly 6.
4. It's episode 4. I've just checked.
Really?
Yeah. The last time we did an episode was... We shot the last episode on October the 6th, so we are very late with this.
Okay. Right. I'll do an intro then. So let's get going. Hey, guys. Welcome back to another episode of RS Chats. Been nearly 2 months, Paul, since we sat down and had a little chat.
2 months. Jeez.
That sound right?
It was at least a month ago, wasn't it?
But most, if it's October 6th, the last time we put one out, it was the week previously that we shot it, so...
Yeah, so Jesus. It's...
Wow. Yeah. Well, it's 24th of November now. Yeah.
What?
24th of November
yeah.
now, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Oh, 2 months. Yeah. 2 months, time's flying. Been busy, though, haven't we?
Yeah, very
been
busy.
Been very busy.
Well, we was going
to... Can't do Wednesday nights.
No, because you're too busy winning quizzes.
I can't do Thursday nights a lot, because I've just been to... been out to a load of gigs and stuff.
Oh.
I've been to see The Mission. Yeah. If you're in the US, that's The Mission UK.
Yeah.
Old goth band. Darth Marenghi.
Yeah, whoever they are.
Darth.
Oh, yeah, sorry. That's not Darth Marenghi.
Sisters last night.
Yeah. So is this your Thursday
sisters
night?
Sisters at Murphy. It's just the way they fall.
Yeah. Well, it's a Monday. No, it's not just Monday. It's a Saturday.
It's not a Saturday either.
It's a Friday, isn't yeah. it?
You're almost there. Third time's a charm. You've done pretty well there.
What day is it? Who am I?
What day is it? Not Monday, and it's not
Jesus
Saturday.
Jesus Christ, yeah. I prefer it than Thursday, because I'm usually doing my thing on a Thursday, aren't I?
Yeah, so, your gym.
Yeah.
How do you know when someone goes to the gym?
Because they tell you about it all the time.
Yeah.
So that's why you talk about cock all the time, is it?
Oh, wait a minute.
Clarky's just disappeared.
Get back in here, I'm going to... Your parcel's come. I don't know.
I spent all the cast.
We're going to have to edit this. We're going to have to start again.
Why?
Because.
No, you can just.
It's so far we've had.
The beginning.
Let's just. Now, like, start again.
You've already used the beginning, haven't you? You've already said the beginning 3 times. Surely you can use one of them.
You say that. Well, that's just edit time, isn't it? Trying to save Clarky time, thinking about Clarky.
We've been filming.
Because I am kind and considerate.
No, you're not.
You should try it sometime.
No, you are not.
I would just like to say, Paul, can you try and keep the external noise to a minimum while we listen to Clarky opening his parcels?
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Yeah, we've been filming for 20 minutes, but we've got nothing to show for it.
You ever thought Clarky about being an MP, Clarky? One rule for one. One rule for everyone else.
What?
It's like he's got
on his phone.
Hang on, his phone's got handles. It's better than that thing you had the other week. What's that?
Put my phone in.
To fucking nothing.
Just got a variable ND for it.
What's going to be next week? He seems to have something different every week.
Oh, every week is a total technophobe.
A technophobe?
No, technophile.
Put a Pornhub app right next to your Amazon app, and I bet you don't order as much stuff, half as much stuff.
Did that work for you?
Very noisy.
Has it got the optical inch?
I thought you were doing another intro.
No, we're filming now. We've been filming for the past 15 minutes.
We can't really do anything because all we can hear is...
So inconsiderate, isn't it?
How can you hear it? You haven't got headphones in?
What's that? What's that?
We can hear it in real life. What's he got? Has he got something to put on his imaginary phone?
Yeah.
Have you seen it? My first phone.
It's like, what, give the baby to play with at home? Right, okay, so 22 minutes in and nothing done.
No, we've just done another 5 minutes of content for you.
With what?
Mate. You'll find it. Yeah.
Just stick this on the end if you want to bump the time up, because we're not going to get an hour today. Paul's got to go soon. But anyway, hi guys. Welcome to RS Paul Chats with Rob and Clarky Eavesdrop in the corner of the room. Mm-hmm. It's been almost 2 months since we...
Clarky eavesdrops yet leads the podcast because you two have not planned anything.
It's been 2 months since we last sat down and chatted.
Yeah, we could have planned it, but it was going to be next Monday and now it's Friday and you're just like...
Yeah.
You do it today? Because she changed it.
Yeah. I like to keep you, you know.
Well, it was meant to be last Thursday, but someone cried it off.
You cried it off?
You.
Why did I cry it off?
Because you're going to the gym.
No, I wasn't.
How do you know someone goes to the gym?
No. Cece was there.
No.
That last now?
No.
Yeah.
That was the week before.
I didn't cry off last Thursday.
I'm sure you did.
No.
Wait a minute. Did Clarky cry off last Thursday?
I don't know. When you lot cried off?
I think Clarky might.
I was ready to give up then. I was like, oh, right, nice one. I'm going to the gym now. Because one of you cried off.
I think it was Clarky. I didn't have anything on last week.
Oh, yeah, I had to go and pick the baby up.
Do you remember the one where Rob was like, he went... Shit. Sorry, guys.
That was it. Weren't we like half an hour into
filming? We started that one.
Oh my god!
Yeah, we started. I didn't realise I had an appointment.
Terrible.
I look at him. I didn't realise I had an appointment. But you forgot someone was coming off Facebook Marketplace to buy something off you.
Yeah, don't say that. Let's get going then, Clarky.
Rob,
hit us up with your first observation.
Well, so we've got. Just obviously, so this is just us recapping on stuff. So the big thing at the moment, and I was, when I wrote this as number one,
AI,
I was so confident we were going to have signed it off.
The war in Palestine.
The RS Hall of Fame calendar.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Which has now just hit another little bump, speed bump in the road, hasn't it?
Yeah.
It was ready to go. Whoever's breathing like that, stop it.
Stop breathing, Paul.
It's you, Rob.
It's foot tapping. I'll start saying.
See your frog neck moving to it.
If you stop him, if you stop him from doing one thing, he'll just go on to the next.
How's that?
Well, you've consciously controlling your breathing right now. So yeah, so the Hall of Fame calendar is the.
What were you doing? Just looking it off.
Well, he's just going...
Like being in Jabba's palace, isn't it?
Go on, continue. I'm sorry for putting you off.
You're not putting me off. It's the people who listen to this or watch it. It's probably worse than watching it, because they're like, how can a man like sat that still breathe like that?
Did you say worser?
I don't think I did.
You did? I like it.
Worser.
Yeah.
He can't say worser, though, can he? It's got an R at the end.
Yeah, I can't say anything with an R in. Broderick. Release Broderick. Well...
Anyway, yeah, so things that have been going on in the last 8 weeks since we recorded, 7 weeks, is the Hall of Fame calendar, but that's just hit a little hurdle to do with I've made it so big that when you unfold it, the weight of the paper wouldn't be able to hold it on the wall.
How big is it?
It's almost as big as the noise that Rob's making while he breathes.
Oh my god, that's a lot of weight.
Yeah, it's a 312-inch page, but there's two of them, so then it's like 24 inches long, isn't it?
Right, okay, so you're making it a bit smaller now.
No, we're just
sticking with it.
Trying to find the heavier paper.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I know. So if you unfolded the cover, which would reveal Mr. January,
yeah,
and January's month underneath, as soon as you hung it up, it just ripped through the paper because of the weight of the 11 months.
So what do they usually do? They always rip through anyway, at some point, don't they?
I hope not.
Of course they do. Everyone's kind of just ripped through. You just got to fix them. So have you decided on which month's what?
I mean, there are ways to get around it, because you just fold up the back and double up the cover.
Oh, my God.
To hold it.
And there's the voice of experience.
These are like little... not uninsurmountable problems.
He learnt this when he used to buy Just 16.
I think it used to be called Just 17, and that was a girls' magazine.
You knew it was a girls' magazine. That was the insult.
I used to buy Smash Hits.
You didn't know?
Yeah, we of course you did. It.
Just 17, apparently.
Smash Hits, and I've all my Take That posters.
I remember remember Big? Got my first Simpsons poster, which had this full life size. If Bart Simpson was real life, had like a 4-foot fold out poster of Bart Simpson.
Is he taking a piss?
It was
Big.
The coolest thing ever. I'm sure it was called Big.
Big. It was called Looking, mate.
Looking. No,
Looking.
I'm not
Looking.
As old as you.
Never heard of it.
Looking was the black newspaper, wasn't it?
I'm too young for these conversations.
Wasn't Looking the, like the newspaper style, kids' newspaper?
No. The magazine.
You just determined to do things to make a noise.
That's what I do.
The coarseness of your rough as fuck hands combined with that bristly beard.
What can
Very
I say?
Manly.
Do you want me to apologise for being so manly?
So anyway, Paul asked a genuine question, which was, have we picked the images for the calendar then? Now, usually I would just be a twat and say, obviously fucking we have, Paul, because we're trying to get it to go to print right now.
Yeah, but the months, obviously, yeah. I don't know. Anything, you've had a pre-print, haven't you? You've had a sample of it.
I have. Yeah. I haven't got it with me, though, because I left it at home for my good lady wife to proofread.
A pre-print.
Proof.
Yeah, well, I haven't seen it.
Well, it was out next to your desk last week.
Was it really?
Yeah, because Pete was stood next to me looking through it. Even Pete was going, that's a cool picture. That's a cool picture.
Really?
And then he went, don't tell anyone or I'll kill you.
Really?
Well, you believe the last bit.
Yeah.
Wow.
I believe some shit, don't I?
I did see it on
You do believe the internet.
I do. Oh, no, you can't believe the internet. Especially YouTube. YouTube news. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
What's YouTube news?
What he listens to? Old fucking Mosley over there.
YouTube news. Anyway.
Okay.
So what were we talking about? What was the...
Well, we're just recapping, aren't we? So we're saying the big things that's been going on.
The calendar.
The current thing's the calendar.
The calendar has been the main thing that's been going on for Clarkie. We've not really been that involved, have we?
No, we've just been getting on with things.
Complaining, don't we? Coming in going... We still can't do it because we're waiting for permission.
Yeah, it does come over to Rob and say, pull your finger out, lad.
I thought he was creating all these problems for a bit of drama in a video, but apparently he's just stuff he's not considered.
No, the only thing I haven't considered...
You've done a good job on it, though, can I just say? I am taking a piss
that's,
a little
that's
bit.
That's the wrong
but
way
you've around. Done a good
what
job.
You do is you lead with the compliment and then you give the feedback on what you should have done better.
Hang on.
You've got to end on the good one.
He has done a good job because he took the best picture in it.
Yes.
Just saying.
Nepotism.
Nepotism's when you're related, not just when we've both been inside your mum.
Oh my God.
Well, all three of us have.
Yeah. We've been in there more than he has now, though. We've gone past that boundary.
Anyway, so the calendar will be getting done. Rob has no faith in it. He keeps saying to me, oh, no, this is going to happen.
Well, I still...
Hang on, he's got the final say, so he's probably going to...
I still wait.
Spanner in the works.
I'm still waiting to see it.
Yeah, like the fact I've had the Hall of Fame coins ready for 6+ months. And
I've seen the proof.
Have you? Yeah. I haven't.
I've seen the proof.
Next events last week.
Yeah, it was there. And looks good.
Nice.
It actually, to be fair, it does look very good.
Yeah, well, I saw the pictures on the screen before he turned it off.
Before I turned what off?
The screen. Just so everyone knows, we usually have a screen in front of us, just like with bits and bobs on it, and he's turned it off because we keep looking at it.
Just to clarify for everyone, it's the cameras. So yeah, they're looking at themselves. There's nothing else on there.
Yeah, sometimes he puts other stuff on. There's another camera pointed towards his groin, so he gives us a bit of a show every so often.
Well, that was the highlight comment on the your photo, wasn't it? Sam Clark's wife commented on how you must have padded out your crotch or something in the underpass.
Oh, yeah, she did, yeah. Oh.
That cake...
A cake, yeah. Thank you very much, Sam, for the cakes. They were lovely.
Sam didn't make
Sam's wife.
Yeah, but he's in charge, isn't he?
No.
Of course he is. And
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know if you can say these things that we think.
Why? Who's watching that won't agree with us?
No, probably no one.
Yep.
Continue.
No one's watching who will agree with us either.
Banana cake.
But anyway, yeah, that Sam's wife.
Yeah.
Lemon drizzle cake was fucking amazing.
And yeah, let me tell you, nice. Let me tell you, the banana cake. Oh my God.
Yeah. So she brought, well, Sam, he brought drizzle cake, lemon drizzle cake.
Two lemon drizzle cakes.
And one banana cake. And Rob took the banana cake to take it home and kept it in the car and ate the whole lot. Say, it
probably didn't make it home.
It didn't.
I didn't keep it in the car. It did make it home and I ate it over
a
number of consecutive days.
Minutes.
But yeah, he ate half our cake, then decided to keep
it. If it makes you feel better, it didn't even get home. I just ate. I didn't even get to get out the car. I just drove home, just ate a full cake like that.
It probably shaped it into a phallic shape.
Yeah, and I sat on it, and then I ate it. If it makes you feel better, well, you can think whatever you like.
Wow, you sat on it.
I had it. I had the banana cake.
Wow. When you sat on it, was there room for the Pringles tin as well?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What was funny, though, is I've never seen Rob as panicked as when we swapped his full banana cake for the half-eaten lemon drizzle cake, he thought Paul and I had eaten it.
That was bang out of order.
Yeah, from the cab on. And he ran out. When he found this full cake, he ran outside and locked it in his car.
Yeah.
That was funny.
To you, maybe.
Yeah, the way it was. Anyway, on to other news of the last month or so.
Yes, please.
Return of the Gold Leader helmet.
Oh, yeah.
We've just packed a few of them up last night.
What do you think about that?
I'm very happy. I was like, what? yeah. Very cool. How many have we got now? How many have we done now?
We've just done 25. We previously did 25, but it was a long time ago.
Mm, yeah.
And we're going to do another batch of 25, time permitting.
Yep.
In it's probably going to be New Year, first quarter next year.
Yeah, yeah.
And then the final 25, probably sometime around summer.
And the wait list is on the website.
Yeah.
I now know how to turn a website on. Fucking hell, doggy. I now know how to turn the wish list on, which means that when Rob announces it and doesn't do it, I'll just be able to do it in future.
Excellent. Because
we had four days of people saying, where's the wait list? Where's the wait? Where is it?
No, delegation.
So it's quite simple. Just go on the website and put the name down on the wish list.
You've got to be signed in, and it'll say wish list just on the page where the Gold Leader helmet is. Last time I looked, the day that we opened up the wish list, we had over 60 names sign up to the wish list. There's obviously not going to be 60 helmets made. So
wait to put them off going on the wish list.
Well, we're not trying to put them off. I'm just saying that it's, you know, people want it, and we will be, something wrong with me today, but we will be, it's because I've had no chocolate.
Well, do not worry, because there's a lot of interesting stuff happening.
If I hadn't been falling over my own words.
All right, okay. Yeah, a lot of interesting stuff going on right now, isn't there?
Yeah, definitely.
A lot of R&D and a lot of finishing off of jobs. And then the hyperdrive thing. Can't talk too much about it.
What can you say about it?
Can we say that Christine and some of the boys are paying us a visit?
That's the only thing we can't say.
Okay.
No, we can't. That's the only thing we can say.
Oh, okay. So how many of them are meeting up there?
We don't know. It's a surprise.
Yeah, it does seem a bit of a surprise. Even Christine doesn't know. When he texted me the other day, it was like, these people are definitely coming. 75%. Chance these are coming, 50% chance these are coming.
Is Tony coming?
I can't confirm or deny.
There's a percentage somewhere of a chance that he will come.
And
Tony's your favourite. Tony's your favourite.
Tony's a nice guy. I like Tony. No, they're all my favourite.
I think Parminder's coming as well.
I like Parminder's.
Parminder's a great guy. He's lovely.
Yeah.
Which one of them don't you like?
Robert McCormick. Hate that.
Nasty, isn't he?
The main man from Portugal's coming as well. Ah, oh, fuck. Roger.
What's his name?
That's what I said. Yeah. You say it for me, please.
No, I can't say it.
It's Roger.
All right, how do you spell it?
R
W
O
O.
I'm confused now. Who are you talking about?
Can I say his surname?
Don't know. Probably not for legal reasons. Yeah. I'll bleep you out.
It's just one of the hyperjack
guys. You say it and I'll bleep you out.
Do you know? Beep. Do you remember? Twat. Celebration. The memory's minute.
Don't mind you calling him. More work for me in the editing stage.
Okay. Well, you should have beeped sooner.
they were the only words I didn't
beep. So there's a guy from Portugal come in, and he's the guy at Celebration. Did you sign that Hyperdrive T-shirt?
No.
Oh, he's the guy that was taking the Hyperdrive T-shirt round to people for them to sign. So, nice guy. He's an avid RS collector. He's got loads of our helmets. So, looking forward to meeting him again. Good luck.
What's his name?
Fuck off.
Roger.
Oh, is it actually Roger?
Yes, it is.
I just thought you were trying to be funny because he can't say his ass.
He runs... he uses his wife or girlfriend's Facebook page. So that's Claudia or Claudia. So whichever. How do you say Claudia in Portuguese? So...
So that like when someone's French and called Pierre and you say, how do you say that in English? And you go, Pierre.
Peter.
So, yeah.
Anyway, Hyperdrive. Guys, they're going to visit. And hopefully we've got some things organised for them to see and do when they arrive. But, yeah, I'm looking forward to that. But we are working on the Hyperdrive, the Christmas Hyperdrive thing. We can't say too much about it because that's for them to talk about.
Mm. Yeah, well,
but I'm excited for it.
Is that usually announced on Christmas Day as well?
Don't know what's happening.
No. Oh, it's just up to them. So
we're going
to
bend our knees and sit down, chat with Christian and work out the finer points.
Excellent.
And if they do it, there's no chance of our website being crashed.
Mm. Yeah.
Nice.
Which is a bonus.
Mm, definitely.
Nice bunch of guys.
It's what's called dead air.
Yeah.
Dead air.
Dead air. That's what's under your hat.
Fucking hell. Mine only died a couple of years ago.
Just while we're on the subject, I think we've got the Christmas episode of the RS Chats coming up, haven't we?
Oh, right, okay.
And I think you should sing a Christmas carol. And I think people should comment below if they want to hear Paul sing.
Is it not bad, isn't it?
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
I think you'll find that I won't be singing it because I'd have probably left RS by then.
Because I'd be crying.
Crying.
Quiet. You should have said quiet then. You fat mess. Okay, next.
Next. So I had the privilege to be in the background for Rob's last podcast that he recorded, which will be going out this evening.
So it's already out. So do check that out.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, by the time this goes out. There you go. Rob's got more of a grip on the time. Yeah. I know.
All right, cool. Time is made up.
But, so Rob sat down virtually with Jez from Star Wars Helmets.
Virtually, because it wasn't there, no.
Yeah, we had a Blade Runner video call.
Wow, did you have him on the screen? Was the telly turned on?
There was technology, there was TV to look at.
Oh, my God.
There was all weird technology going on at his end as well.
How's Jez doing? Getting warm now.
He's doing very well.
Yeah. What did you talk about? Anything good? Have we got to wait till... Listen to it.
It'll have been out by the time this goes out, so we can drop a few bits out of it.
Yeah.
I just, from my point of view, he was just very interesting to listen to.
Yeah, he is.
There was we had a little bit of a plan of, like Rob and I usually have, you know, how we want to steer the conversation or, you know, points we want to talk about. But it was great, not only because Jez was very interesting, but Jez filled the podcast enough that Rob barely said anything, which is obviously even better.
How did you fill Rob up?
No, he didn't. It's just because Jez... No. So
he wasn't in the room.
Paul.
Yes.
When I'm with someone that I'm interested in.
Clarky.
I'm a good listener.
What we're going to do over Christmas? We haven't discussed that. Yeah.
Me and you were going out for a drink at some point,
aren't yeah. Or several.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Top and tail in the van.
Yeah. Again, like we did on the when we took the picture for the car, aren't we? Anyway, Jez.
All I can say, Paul, is
go on, Wobbit.
Yeah, go on, Bobby.
I'm a good listener.
Blobby. No, you're not.
Yeah.
Well, you've got to start talking about yourself at some point. It must have started.
No, I was. Are we keeping you up?
Yeah.
No. Just set him off talking and then listened.
It's dead interesting.
I just sponged it all up.
Yeah. Well, he's been doing that a few years now, though, hasn't he?
20 years.
Yeah, that's what we established.
20 years?
Yeah. 20 years. Oh, man and boy. God.
He's only about 30, isn't he?
He looks like he could be related to cat food, I thought.
As in? He's posh.
Glasses and well-spoken, that was about it.
That's it.
Yeah. I was going to say, looks like a Doctor Who or something like that.
I think that's a big compliment to cat food, isn't it?
Cat food looks like a Doctor Who?
Yeah, it looks like it looks like the first Doctor Who, doesn't it?
Looks like someone who knew Jimmy Savile.
He could be Jimmy Savile's dad.
Especially with that butt plug we know he bought recently.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
That's cat food.
It's a magic trick.
Cat food Rob I'm talking about, not Jez.
Yeah. So, cat food Rob let Clarky get hold of his phone. And Clarky went, what's this in your recent browser history? And it did look like a butt plug. Not that I've ever seen one.
Yeah,
and Catherine went, that's a magic trick.
If you're watching the video, this is what it looked like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But no, the best thing
was... Who made the best joke about it?
Pete.
Yeah, Pete said, watch me make it disappear.
But the funniest thing was when hours later, it was obviously still on Rob's mind, and he sent a message. Was it direct to you or was it in a group chat?
He sent it to me and I sent it to you.
He sent a picture saying it can't be a butt plug, it's too small. Clarky replied, how big it usually.
Brilliant. And
insert screenshot. If you're watching, if you're not watching on YouTube and you're listening on the podcast, it was like an egg cup sized, like weird magic trick thing that looked suspiciously like a butt plug.
And cat food usually turns up every either Thursday or Friday or both days.
He's not been in this week.
He's not been in this week.
Has anyone checked on him?
No.
I'll do it now.
I think you've shamed him.
It's going to be in the paper, isn't it?
Yeah.
Man found with magic trick hanging out of ass.
You keep trying to pull it out, but I keep pulling rabbits out.
When I just opened up the...
pulling out one of the big string of handkerchiefs.
Oh, you're a magic stick, though. You can do that.
Just when I opened up my messages to him, it was just full screen. Magic tricky.
Oh, my God, that's funny. Oh,
I mean, cat food's been on the vlogs quite often, videos quite often. And so everyone knows cat food, don't they? So you know who we're talking about.
Well, who recently
the guy with the cravats and the waistcoats.
Somebody asked recently, does cat food Rob actually work at RS, didn't he?
Yeah. No, he didn't.
He's just actually a hanger-on.
It's a bit of an insult for cat food.
That is a bit cruel, that.
Yeah.
You know?
Okay, is a big hanger-on? I was going to say a little one before. Sorry.
Is that like he says it's a little, yeah, little plug?
No. He's ever since I've met cat food, he's constantly been a great help to RS. Research and development has helped out a lot over the years. We just have to open the books for him because he doesn't like touching paper and stuff like that. He has servants for stuff like that, doesn't he?
He does at home, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, good bloke.
Good bloke. He's never been that much help to me when I'm trying to record a video and he's in the background criticising whatever Rob's saying.
Yeah. He is, well, as well, if anyone's seen his internet presence, he does criticise anything and everything.
He used to criticise some of the videos at one point, and then I found out he was watching them on like a 12-year-old iPad.
Yeah, that's our cat food.
Yeah. So yeah, cat food, we love you, and we hope you make a quick recovery and the doctors remove it easily.
Yeah.
But what we were talking about is the podcast with Jez.
Oh yeah.
And that, yeah, it was I mean, it was good. I don't like to get all chatty with it because there's no point. The whole point of him being here is to learn from Jez. So, you know, we can do this and I can talk shite with you. So when Jez is there, I just shut up and listen.
Ah, oh, nice.
Yeah, well, so I've got I've taken three clips, you know, to put out as reels over the next couple of days to tease. And even like having listened to it, I think they're fascinating to like the little bits of the stories. Or sorry, the big stories he had, and just these little bits that surely are going to make you want to go, what? I need to know who he's talking about.
Yeah.
So something I loved that he said, and I'll give it away a little bit, he talked about going to what Rob referred to as Empire Day when Empire Strikes Back was released in the early 83?
Mm-hmm.
And how he...
No, 84. See, 80.
80?
Yeah.
Oh, Jedi was 83 or something, wasn't it? So when in 1980, he hounded the, was it Lucasfilm at the office in London or something?
Yep.
He hounded them and he was a kid, like preteen.
Mm.
And he hounded them, could he go to the premiere? And they sent him two tickets.
Wow.
Yeah. And he said he had to go with his brother. But his brother didn't even like Star Wars, but his mum and dad wouldn't let him go by himself. And he had to put a black black tie and suit on to go and attend it, yeah.
At that age. And he lived in Leicester at the time, still lives in Leicester. Yeah. So he went all the way from Leicester to London for the premiere. And if you're not in the UK, he went all the way from Leicester in London to London for the premiere.
Yeah, so it's definitely worth a listen to. Because I, like with this podcast, for example, when I edit it, I'll be pulling my hair out, my beard hair out, because it'll stress me out because there's so much I have to take out of it. The one with Jez was... so good. There was nothing I had to take out of it apart from we had some technical difficulties with Zoom when we were recording it. We had to stop a few times, but other than that, it was just perfect story time.
Well, they do say you don't work with children and animals, and you got both of them sat right
children,
there.
Children, animal.
Yeah. Only an animal wearing around your mum's.
Fat hippopotamus. I suppose you could get it up, you fat hippopotamus.
She's a very helpful lady. You should know that.
Rob's mum is a very helpful lady, apparently.
Allegedly. So, other things we've done recently was we did a video which went down really well, and then Rob peaked in it, which was Rob shot a load of stuff on the days I wasn't here.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And we put like a lo-fi video together with interspliced with some stuff that Rob and I shot later in the week.
Beat.
I thought you just called him Pete, but you said feet, didn't you?
Yeah.
Is he twitching? The telly's in my way. I can only see his head.
His hands are still 2 feet of stairs. Uh-huh. You start tap dancing when your hands stop moving. And tiny feet. But yeah, he did do a good video, didn't he? Safe to say, your job's still safe, though. But, it's quite good fun that week, wasn't it?
We're just going to capture a little bit more of the...
I enjoyed that.
BTS, aren't we?
Yeah. Mm. I enjoyed that. I mean, you didn't tell us. And I walked in, I was like, have you still got a microphone on from last night? And he was like, I was like, what? And you didn't explain what you was doing. Then I saw a camera on you and thought, oh, right, that's why you're asking me questions so early in the morning.
That's how you know what an absolute narcissist he is, that he has cameras on himself and he doesn't explain it to anyone. Like if I'm doing something, I'm like, I'm just doing this. This is why this is here, I'm doing it.
Oh yeah, I had to work it out what's going on.
It doesn't make any sense what he's saying. If I've got a camera on, it means I'm not filming myself.
Well,
if you've got a camera on you, this camera's on me, that camera's on you, that camera's on Paul, that camera's on the boat.
No, I was wearing it filming him.
Yeah, yeah, he had... At first I saw a mic on him. I was like, why has he got a mic on him? Then I realised he had a camera on him as well.
So you mean on him physically?
On him, yeah. On
not
his
like,
person.
Not like that camera.
Like a GoPro, yeah.
No. Filming others.
I didn't understand it though, because it was situated on his belt buckle. So it took me a while to notice.
No, it took you till you got down on your knees in front of him.
Shit, yeah.
No, it's the first place he looks.
I need to make sure that the general's still in working order. And it's not.
I'm hoping we can do a bit more. Like, I forgot all about it actually, and just been really busy.
Just to clarify, Rob forgetting about it means he's ignored the messages.
And there was no necessity for it.
Are you doing this? Have you done it? But this is. Thought you wanted fly on the wall.
Hmm?
So you can't say there's not a necessity for it, or you're too busy. There's, those words don't exist in Fly on the Wall.
Well, well.
So what you're saying is, I understand what you said originally, Clarky, which is why we can't do Fly on the Wall, but maybe just a little bit more BTS will do.
Well, watch this space, I would say. Let's see. Sounds like a challenge.
Mm. Right, you'll notice in a few months, as Rob will say that sentence back to me, what I've just said. But he'll have his own spin on it. So he made it his own. More dead air. Nice, okay.
I thought, well, you were talking, I thought, you just went to a dream world.
I'm thinking about that chocolate.
Your headset's not straight.
My ears aren't straight.
Oh, shit, it's your ear, sorry. Freaking forget. Okay, next, go on.
Unrelated.
Oh, are we still with Jazz?
No, unrelated, okay. But because I've thought of his post this week and the prince behind him, it's Dave Kennedy's stopped doing conventions, hasn't he?
Oh, yeah, he's moved on to more serious, well, not more serious stuff, but he's
moving on to being a licensed artist.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
Which is amazing.
Good looks and stuff.
Yeah. Good luck to him.
He did talk about a few of the bits he was doing when he was here, wasn't he?
But yes,
It's amazing that he's now kind of, it's his, with that art always been his full time, well, for a long time, hasn't it? But it's nice to see that he's going in the direction that he's been working towards.
Yeah.
So, Dave, nice one.
Yeah, good luck, Dave. Miss you.
I don't think he needs it.
I suppose it's quite challenging, isn't it, to carry on selling online? I wonder if it'll still be selling online.
No, I don't think so.
Wow.
Don't think so.
I suppose if he's just tinkering full time doing comics and what have you.
Tinkering full time. Is that a thing?
Don't know. I couldn't tell you what tinkering is really nowadays.
Tinkering to me just sounds like something you just potter about with on the side.
Insert mum joke here.
No.
So Bausch LEDs.
Yeah.
Obviously Bausch isn't.
How far back have you gone here?
I've gone back to when we did the last video. Last podcast.
Oh, all right, 2 months then.
Well, 7 weeks or so, yeah.
7 weeks.
So, yeah. So
2 months, give or take.
Bausch LED.
Yeah. We've got a Bausch update coming, haven't we?
Yeah.
We really need one. When I don't know when this is going out and when that's going out, but yeah, there's developments afoot on the Bausch.
Mm-hmm.
So if you've not seen the update, do check out our YouTube channel. And if you can't see it, it's because it's not there yet, but it will be coming soon.
You were doing so well at talking in the non-linear time, and now you've just...
Yeah, but that I knew about, this I don't know about.
So have the LEDs not been shown on video yet?
Yeah.
Oh, they have, right, okay. Can't remember. I remember watching you try.
You've seen them, haven't you?
I remember Clarky had your son, Connor, and they had a battery pack and they were trying them all out, weren't you?
Mm-hmm.
So I have seen them.
So I can't remember what any of them were, but we had the last Q&A, which always goes down well. No point really addressing that. And one thing interesting that we were talking about Hyperdrive earlier, and this is the last thing really to talk about now, was the Hyperdrive update on the...
Done.
Yeah.
Finished.
Yeah.
Complete. Funnily enough, one of the guys was on holiday and he asked us not to ship his helmet, but it has now shipped. And that is the last one. And it was actually number 99. So there is 100.
Yeah.
But it was number 99 left today.
Nice.
Oh, it's just gone today.
Yeah.
On the day of filming,
we were asked to hold on to it so that he'd be there to take delivery, and that's gone now to Richard. He'll probably receive that tomorrow. So, as you're watching this, he's probably got it.
Nice, yeah, it was good. It was good on that one. Simon was working from home to be undisturbed for that one, wasn't he?
And the gold leader as well.
Yep. Yeah, well, that was it. That was the one that snuck under the radar, wasn't it? No one was expecting that announcement. Which I suppose, if you want to talk about trying to do that as the new way to avoid pre-orders.
Well, that's what's going on with
Yeah.
with the Bausch and the R&D that we're doing and trying to get in front of the curve rather than being behind it all the time. So, yeah, we've tried a few things, haven't we? And they're working out well. Hence the lack of Black Friday, because that we've realised that that absolutely screws with all of our timeline and plans. So we've just had to suck that up. We'll see. Maybe we can do something more staged and localised throughout the year on specific things, as opposed to just like a complete free-for-all on Black Friday. So we're going to look at some options on what may be possible. But yeah, that certainly helped with finishing that off, and with the there's two lovely projects that we're currently working on that are actually being worked on right now, not just planned and thought about. And well, that's going to be great when we get round to it. They are on. Sean is building stuff, and we've been building some stuff in here.
Yep.
And stuff is formed and ready, and yeah, there's stuff going on, which is I'm excited about.
And that's about as much as you can say as well.
Yeah, I'm excited about it because it's happening. This new way of working is definitely the gold leader, I think, has shown that we can make it work. So
it's quite difficult to hide in it from the videos as well, because the hyperdrivers,
all the gold leaders have gone now as well.
Yeah, because the gold leaders, some of them turned up on one of the videos, didn't they?
Yeah, somebody commented.
The hyperdrivers commented, didn't they? Which was quite cool.
What, the previous numbers?
Yeah.
Yeah, it would be nice to locate. I've got some of the numbers.
That's not what he's talking about.
All right.
Talk about that in a minute. What Paul means is somebody commented on one video because there was a gold leader helmet in the background.
Oh, right.
Yeah, which had slipped through our due diligence of trying to hide these things.
Yeah.
But it was obviously one of the ones that was kicking about ready to be finished was lurking in some eagle-eyed
view. Yeah, it was cool to get back on the gold leader, and it was cool to the way it fitted in with the way the rest of the team was working and who was available to do it, and it just worked like a charm, didn't it? So that's definitely the way I would like to go.
So what, because I've got a question to lead in a second, but you were talking about the plaques when I cut you off then.
The numbers.
The original numbers.
Yeah, well, I'm absolutely positive we did 25 because I remember us physically having 25, because I've got this weird part of me being on the spectrum is definitely the multiples of stuff. And we definitely had 25, but I can only seem to find records for 20. So I'm not sure where the other five went, but I know that they're out there. And I'm trying to work out what numbers are where and who's got what so we can get the plaque numbers correct on the next batch of them. Because I've got a feeling Simon's took one. So we're up to 26. So the next one should be 27, but I need to confirm all of that.
Okay.
Yeah, so if you've got if you're on the original run of the first 25, get in touch with us, let us know what your number was, tell your order number and your plaque number. And send it to media, rspropmasters.com, studio, rspropmasters.com, info, rspropmasters.com.
Now, the plaques were different.
Yeah.
On the first batch of them, they weren't numbered, but we've had all the plaques redone, so I do want to try and get all the plaques swapped so that everybody has got the exact same one, which is a nice numbered plaque. Well, I think we were trying something different at the time, and obviously we've not gone back to that. We've gone back to the original metal plaques. So, it'd be nice to get them all to their correct homes.
Yeah. That's very decent of you.
So go back to what you were saying about the way forwards of working. I'm going to play devil's advocate here and ask a question that is, I'll put money on, is going to end up in the comments. The Bausch run it's slightly behind.
Mm-hmm.
And originally you said, everyone's working on Bausch, no one's going to work on anything else. Mm-hmm. What's changed in that process, and what have you learned, which has changed the way other things are going to be done, if we've managed to produce 25 gold leader helmets without anyone knowing and have somebody working on the hyperdrive run without anyone knowing?
What's changed?
Yeah.
We've not been put 3 months behind by a Black Friday event. I think that's one of the big things. But we find when you're working on a project like the Bausch helmet, there are natural bottlenecks which will occur. Now, we can do things to try and alleviate that, but only up to the point where the team can do that. So as long as we're always ready so that we can keep work, so we're at a maximum on that natural bottleneck, or, you know, that's our biggest bandwidth. So as long as we've got enough work for that, then the rest of the team can be working on other things. But we're also in front on certain parts of it, and there's no reason why we can't complete certain parts of it, and then it will all catch up and it will all be at the finish line at the same time.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Right, well, Rob said we wouldn't get an hour out of this, and we've got an hour and 16 minutes. And
no way.
But I've got to get rid of the first 20 minutes.
Yeah.
I know you can use a bit of it. You'll work your way around it.
You could just have 4 minutes of silence at the end with the camera on Paul.
Do you remember when I did that on a video? And be like,
yeah.
What video? That was...
we did a video and Clarky was trying to get the watch minutes up because he was really like...
No, that's not what happened.
It's when we were... It was the early days.
Yes, I remember.
That's not what happened at all. Well, there was the one where Rob actually said Rob was determined to make every video 11 minutes, 38 seconds long, which was like the bane of my life. And at one point he was like, just put like a 20-second outro on it. But the problem was, as soon as we exported it, because like the editing software looks at it in tenths of a second, I could export it at like 11 minutes, 38 seconds, but then YouTube would interpret it differently, and YouTube would class it as 11 minutes, 39 or 11 minutes, 37. And he had me up the wall for a couple of weeks trying to make every video 11 minutes, 38 seconds.
Bloody hell. You do have it tough, don't you?
I know. I know what the kids are like.
Bloody hell.
So anyway, what have we got coming up then?
Coming up,
we've got the Hyperdrive guys.
We have
Hyperdrive guys visiting.
Yeah, so we've got the hype there coming up.
Moved away from the microphone.
Hopefully, the calendar's going to get done.
Yeah. Hopefully.
So by the time this is going to go out, Jez's podcast will be out, so make sure you have a listen to that. We're going to have a Bausch update in the next couple of weeks.
Yes.
And then we're going to have the Christmas video.
Yes.
/ and or year review.
Yes.
So last year we did like a one video of a Christmas and year review, whereas Rob's talking this year about maybe doing one as a Christmas video and one as a year review.
Right, okay.
Right, are we wrapping us up then?
Are we wrapping it up?
I think we made that joke last time.
Yeah. Can keep it'll doing it.
Wrap it up for Christmas.
Yeah, there you go.
Beep, beep. Okay, so we've got quite a few things coming up. It's going to be a nice run into the end of the year, and then a great start to next year. If you want to hear more about that, then tune in next time. But until then, this has been Paul boring the arse off you.
Mm-hmm. This has been Rob being a twat. Peace out. And you got to say bye.
Good evening.
Goodbye.